Lately, USA is getting scarier. Half of the Americans I see all hate America. They hate the cops doing their best to take care of us and kneel for the flag and salt the soldiers that we're burying. I'm tired of the pissing and complaining. Why you living in America if all you do is hate it? You think it's brave to take a stand against a nation? Real bravery is dying for the right so you can say it. Dear America, what happened to Americans? Apparently no one's aware or cares that it's embarrassing. It's arrogance. Our greatest enemy was always slavery and terrorists. And now it's people in the country trying to burn the heritage. I can't help it, I just seem to see the world different. It ain't Republicans or liberals, it's mental illness. The internet is only interested in left opinions. Cancel culture's got more power lately than the First Amendment. If you don't like it, leave, we will not defund police. We don't want no riots in our neighborhoods or in the streets. We respect freedom of speech, we protect what we believe. We don't want nobody dead, so please do not tread on me. In America, your freedom ain't free. In America, got soldiers dying overseas. So America, my America, I won't ever take a knee.
Our freedom is the reason you can disrespect our flag. If my stars and stripes offend you, then I'll help you pack your bags.
America, does anybody know what the hell happened to the Patriots? Lately this nation is so ashamed and hating itself. Did everyone forget that people died to pay for this? Ungratefulness, United States gave everything to you just to help. I just wanna celebrate Thanksgiving with my family. I don't need your help to understand it was a tragedy. Can I just be thankful for my country eating happily? Without you trying to guilt me for the genocide and casualties? I can't help it, I just seem to see the world different. It ain't black or white, it's conflict designed by the system. I don't need your pronouns, all I see is men.
I'm telling you, man, smoke these dudes. you gonna get off. Female automatically in a position of vulnerability. As far as the law is concerned, we ain't gonna be mad at you. What he did, he was being aggressive. Smoke him. I talked to one of the investigators. I asked him. I said, "How many women murderers do you see?" He said, "Not a lot of them." He said, "Usually, when a woman murders a man, it's usually based in domestic violence." And I was like, that makes sense. Yeah, man, honestly, bro, y'all have to understand. These people are traumatized. They're scared. They're hurt. They're confused. And they're still relying on the mentality of somebody whose life is getting worse and worse and worse in front of them. So there's a major internal conflict. And I'm not giving you an opinion at this point. I'm giving you direct experience. The war is not with us. There's no lower self and there's no Babylon. What they're fighting against is their own good judgment versus what Eligio Bishop told them to do and told them to say. So whereas you see somebody lying and you see somebody stupid, that's not what's happening. What you're watching in real time is somebody having one of the most deepest internal battles you ever gonna see. Some of y'all done had these battles too, but it ain't online. You trying to figure out if you was going to stay with your baby dad or not. You trying to figure out if he was going to change. Your internal battle, you had internal battles too. You stayed with your baby daddy for 5 years and you knew you was supposed to leave him on year one. So what is we talking about? The only difference between you and Aya and Ephraim Aaliyah is that your internal battles ain't online. That's it. That's it. Some of y'all done had internal battles with what your mama wants you to do. Your mama wants you to go to this school. She wants you to go to this job. Your daddy wants you to be this. And your daddy wants you to be that. But you didn't like none of their recommendations. But it took you 2 years to stand up. It took you 2 years to stand. It took some of y'all 10 years to stand up to your mama. So what's we talking about? You get to mosey on in here on the internet in your false position of authority because you know nobody's seen your struggles. But if we were to put your struggles on YouTube, you wouldn't be in the position to say nothing. All you would need is a head wrap and you'd be Aya. All you need is a head wrap and you'd be Malia. All some of y'all need is a head wrap and you'd be Efru. So what are we talking about? But go ahead and act like you some type of genius that got all your whole life figured out. I'm serious. Y'all acting like, I don't know why people be getting on this internet acting like, girl, look at this. And girl, let's look at your life. What is you talking about? Your boyfriend slapping you upside the head? Nah. Your boyfriend tell you who you can be friends with, where you can go, who you can talk to, and how much money you can spend. Some of y'all in a cult right now with one person. But you know what, y'all? Moonchild, it ain't even about judging them. You know what it's about? You know what it's about, dog? It's about looking at yourself and asking yourself, what do I want for these people? What do I want for these people? And is what I'm doing helping that situation or not? Honestly, y'all know what would be crazy. I'm going to tell y'all something that would be crazy, right? That'll mess their head up. If everybody, and when I say everybody, if everybody stopped paying attention to them. That'll mess their head up, bro. If they went on YouTube and nobody was recording their videos and nobody was putting them on thumbnails, because what we do is feeding their belief that they're in this war. If every time they went live, nobody was saying nothing, nobody was recording, nobody was commenting, that'll mess their head up. Because this machine runs off of the belief that we're evil. That'll mess their head up, bro. That's what I'm saying. They really believe the world is against them. But if there's no opposition, you have no carbonation. I try to stick with the most honest opinion is that I don't know. They could literally continue to follow this man to the day they die, just like Warren Jeffs. Warren Jeffs is way beyond appeal. Warren Jeffs will never see the outside of a prison. But there's people that continue to follow him to this day. Yeah, and Manson had followers too. Some members hang on for life. And so I had to stop watching them, y'all. I had to stop watching them. If they leave, they leave. If they don't, they don't. That's where I'm at this point, bro. I tried to reach out to Juju. I tried to reach out to Jax. You know what I'm saying? And I wasn't surprised at their reaction. But it's out of my hands. It never was in my hands, so. Hey, that's straight up fire. And it's not far-fetched. Look at your relationships. Let's look at some of our relationships, y'all. How many times did we hang on to somebody thinking they was going to change? And then we realized, oh, snap. We had to, as hard as it was, this person was incapable of being what we needed them to be. Nah, bro, I rock with Apple. Listen, Android is doo-doo trash. I look at Android the same way I look at PlayStation. If I only rock with Xbox, I only rock with Microsoft, and I only rock with Apple. And I'm not about to retype that book, and I'm not about to re-upload that book. Oh, you can't change them, folk. I'm telling you, pretty brown skin, 13 years? How many of y'all was married? Some of y'all know. How many of y'all was married 6, 7, 8 years? Thinking your husband or wife was going to change. That's possible, JoJo. Only time will tell. I left Twitch, Shakes. I ain't streaming on Twitch. Holla at me on COD Mobile. I record my own videos. Twitch talking about some, be careful not to show anything on your phone. Because I'm like, bro, ain't nobody about to be worried about streaming Call of Duty and somebody seeing some sensitive, confidential information on my phone. I screen record my own games and put them on Instagram. I can't do multiple social medias. That's why I just stick with Instagram. So Twitch is gone. I put the screen record button on, clip my own videos, and put them on Instagram. Or I'll make a YouTube channel with nothing but me shooting folks with fire music in the background. That's why I think I'm about to make a gamer YouTube channel of me just shooting folks on Call of Duty Mobile. But it'll be like trap beats in the background. So, yeah, Twitch is done. Thank you for sharing that, pretty brown skin. Nah. Go ahead, Shakes. You got it. You got it. I'm telling you, Amari, thank you for sharing. The only difference between carbonation and your life is the fact that it was on the internet. That's it. That's it. That's it, dog. Yes. Exactly, Moonchild. Exactly. But I ain't gonna keep y'all too long, man. It was good talking to y'all this morning. Y'all enjoy the rest of y'all day. That's it, man. We'll get up next time, all right? Holla at y'all. Because I can't think of everything. And I don't know everything. What's up, Fat Black? Some of y'all be adding some really good analysis when it comes to this case study. Because that's how I treat it now. I treat carbonation like a case study. I understand why Rick Ross became a cult expert. I understand why people study psychology. I understand why people are fascinated by this. What's up, Black? You know, people had the nerve to ask me how long I was going to talk about this. And people had the nerve to tell me that I don't need to keep talking about this because I'm keeping Nature Boy and carbonation alive. And I want to point out that it's been 80 years since the Holocaust, and the Jews continue to acknowledge it. It's been 20 years since September 11th, and the United States continues to acknowledge it. It's been 400 years since slavery started, and African Americans continue to acknowledge it. It's been not even 2 weeks since a verdict was reached. And people are acting as if they have an issue
with me continuing to talk about this. I will continue to talk about this because this is my life. I'm going to talk about it forever if I want to. And exactly, Ruth, you took the words right out of my mouth. The motive is awareness, because awareness breeds prevention. The survivors of People Temple recently had a 45-year anniversary. I feel like people who want to silence the victims want to promote the perpetrator. I agree, Black. I said the same thing. I said a lot of people that are supporting Eligio Bishop think like him and exhibit some of his same behaviors. You know, everybody says that, ready or not. Everybody says that. I want to bring awareness and exposure. Because Albert Einstein said that the world would not be destroyed by bad people, but by good people who stand by and do nothing. Thank you, Elmo. See, y'all go hard. Y'all go hard. People think you need therapy. Oh, I need the therapy you think I should get. So I have to be on a couch. I can't talk about it. You say I need therapy, and when I use therapeutic techniques, you don't like them. because it's not the therapy you want me to get. Okay. Thank you for that, Elmo. That's true. Hey, what's going on, Breeder Boss? Y'all go get y'all hair did. Breeder Boss is a master cosmetologist. Where you out of, Bree? Where you out of? Oh, yes, Aaliyah. Somebody else sent me that quale. I didn't even know Zora Neale Hurston said that. That don't hit the nail on the head. I'm telling you, Black, they want me to do quiet therapy. If you are silent about your pain, they'll kill you and say you enjoyed it. Straight up. That was fire. Shout out to Zora Neale Hurston. People don't, I think she's an underrated woman. Oh, she, hey, y'all, hey, Brian Atlanta, check out. Oh, yeah, we're going to put you on Front Street. That quote is so powerful. Yeah, we're going to put you on Front Street. Straight up. Because you see that these cult leaders are not stopping. They're not even hiding no more. So we got to be able to be aware so that we can prevent. That's it. Because I didn't think cults existed today. And I dang sure didn't think Black people got in them. Now that my awareness has expanded, I realize that cults are Mexican, Asian, all races, Indian. What cult you was in, JoJo? I'm telling you, Neek. But I ain't watched the program yet, but I seen it. As in, I seen the advertisement. The Black Hebrew Israelites? Uh-oh. Straight up, Miss Fat Black. That's it. That's why I took them videos down. Do I want to be a part of the problem or part of the solution? It's that simple. Exactly, authentically, Erica. Yeah, straight up are cold. I'm telling you, these same folks want us to be quiet, but they talk about us for 6 hours a day. Huh? Huh? Dang, narcissistic. Need to put that narcissistic down. God, if I hit you with that narcissistic. Dang, they try to hit us with that narcissistic. Yo, that program, that junk looked crazy the way it came on. I'm definitely going to check that out. Shoot, Deshaun, I hope not, but we definitely can't take it out the equation. Like, everything that you can think of in a cult, you have to understand that it's possible for the people who still are in carbonation. I haven't taken killing off the table, and I haven't taken suicide off the table. That seems to be a common pattern with cults when they get desperate. That's why I say y'all watch them, man. Y'all watch them. I'm telling you, Earth Angel B, I hope he don't either. Oh, you think, JoJo, we are, JoJo, that one of the first books we read. That boy Steve lay it down, boy. I'm talking about when he get to prison. I'm telling you, Earth Angel, on the recorded line. Yeah, R. Cole. Listen, I recommend everybody start with Netflix. I'm dead serious. Listen, Netflix has series. You got to find it, though. I might post the picture to make it easy for y'all. Netflix got a series called Explained. I can't remember if it's underneath The Mind Explained or if it's underneath Explained. But if you type in Explained on Netflix, on one of them, it'll have an episode called Cults. 30 minutes. Watch it. You know, Steve was in the Moonies. I didn't know nothing about the Moonies. Nah, I don't watch Ruthless. I don't watch dramatized versions of cults. I like to hear the real deal Holyfield. Hey man, I appreciate y'all, bro. All y'all that called the police, that called CPS, that reported pages, that reported PayPals, reported Cash Apps, y'all did y'all thing. We might have hated y'all at the time, but shoot, we used to hate some of the things our parents told us to do that we now doing. Oh, yeah, Amani. Appreciate that. How to be a cult leader. Ted Junk, they're tough. Yeah, checked it. Matter of fact, yeah, that's what I'm going to tell people because that's easy to find. Listen, How to be a cult leader on Netflix. That's where you start right there. Because Netflix is the standard for documentaries. Hulu, whack. And watch Twin Flames Universe on Netflix. But if, yeah, I would start there. That's, appreciate that, Amani, because that Colts episode is hard to find. You know, I still ain't seen Waco yet. I don't even know what that was about. Listen, How to be a cult leader on Netflix. That's where you need to start. Bro, Twin Flame Universe was sad, bro. That joint sad. And they still going. Yeah, hey, Amani, you gonna rock with that Twin Flame Universe. That joint crazy. I'm telling you, Neek, How to be a cult leader. That's where you need to start. Oh, y'all, I'm gonna tell y'all another crazy one. Orgasm Inc. Ted junk crazy, boy. Yeah, it's on season 2. It might be a little hard for people to find. Waco is David Koresh. People's Temple, Jim Jones. Nexium, crazy too. Is LDS the Mexican church? Earth Angel, because I seen that one too. And Keep Sweet, Pray, and Obey, crazy too. Yeah, I seen Move. I seen them. Bruh. It would be dope to have our documentary on Netflix. Me too, Darcelli. That's my thing. I watch fights, documentaries, and chess. I don't watch Ruthless. FLDS. Not LDS. You forgot the F. Weezy F baby. You forgot the F. It's FLDS. Mother God. I ain't seen that one. Y'all need to see Orgasm Inc. That junk crazy, boy. Yeah, I gotta check out the program, darn daughter. I gotta check it out. She said ALDS. Listen, man, I don't know nothing about no documentary, man. If it come out, it's just gonna surprise y'all one day. If it's true, y'all just gonna see it on Netflix one day. Wow. Just drop it off. What, BB? Do I be like, dang, I can't believe I was in a cult? Yeah. Oh, yeah. I watched UFC 299 last night. That joke was good. And I'm waiting on Ryan Garcia versus David Haney. Let's go. Warren Jeffs, that boy, I'm telling you, that boy Warren Jeffs still the cult leader. The cult of Mother God. What that song? I'm telling you, Eddie Murphy, that boy was stealing. That boy was taking pieces of everybody's culture and putting it in a blender and calling it his. Oh, shoot. I don't blame you, Nicole. Oh, HBO Max. Y'all better give me y'all username and password. I ain't about to buy that. I know about Ruthless, but I don't want to watch no dramatized. I want to see the real deal. That boy put every culture in the world in the blender and said, here, original, my knowledge. Just because you put a banana and strawberry in a blender don't mean it's your smoothie. I heard about that, Neek. I heard they wrapped her body up in Christmas lights. Do the free trial on Prime. Trying to give me all these back though. I ain't got to see every documentary, y'all. I ain't got to see all of them, y'all. Y'all try, look, just sign up for the free trial and then remove your debit card and watch it. Like, y'all boys is crazy, bro. I don't have to see all the documentaries in the world. It's okay. It's okay. Listen, just make a fake email on Google and then go get you a prepaid debit card, load it up with $20, and then use that debit card and that fake email address for the free subscription, and then you don't have to worry about canceling it. Y'all want me to jump through all these hoops just so I can get HBO Max for one documentary? Y'all crazy, man. It's okay, bro. It's okay. Listen, man, I give you my username and password, but you gotta make sure you erase it. It's okay, y'all. I'm telling you, Nicole. Listen, Kyvie. Every cult member has contradictory thoughts from time to time. But what you believe about those thoughts is what keeps you there. You believe that those thoughts are demons and that they're trying to drag you out of your current situation. So you battle those thoughts rather than actually move out on them thoughts. Look at you. Look at you, Darcelli. Look at you. A goddamn Netflix junkie. Listen, Jazzy, lucky you, Jazzy, because I didn't know what cults were. I keep telling people over and over again. I'm telling you, Coco, y'all trying to make sure I'm out. I'm out, y'all. God dang. We just want to make sure. I'm out, y'all. Jenny, you is invested, boy. You is invested. Some of y'all going to be at the 40-year Carbonation reunion talking about, I've been watching y'all for 36 years. Y'all ain't going nowhere. Y'all can't leave. I've been watching y'all for 42 years. Okay, Jazzy in the background. Y'all ain't going nowhere. Y'all be dead. I'm talking about y'all be mad. Y'all just as much as involved in this as I am. When Rick Ross was talking about cult members, he was talking about you too. He would describe it. Y'all were scared. When Rick Ross was talking about emotional equity, he was talking about you too. Y'all were like, dang, I'm in the cult too. Only difference between y'all and me is y'all didn't go. Y'all is in Carbonation, bro. Y'all recovering too. Y'all watching me talking about stuff. I hope you recover. You hope you recover too. Y'all act like y'all ain't traumatized. Y'all is in therapy too. Y'all recovering too. Y'all was waiting on a verdict just like me. We all in this together. Y'all talking about, I hope you be a cult expert. Y'all need to be one too. Y'all done seen videos I ain't seen. And I was there. Y'all talking about, did you see when he? No. Y'all talking about you need to be a cult expert. Y'all do too. How y'all done seen videos I ain't seen? That's why I said this bigger than us, bro. Everybody that ever watched Carbonation is affected. Y'all was waiting on y'all was watching the trial more than me. Y'all telling me stuff I said that I don't even remember. I remember when you blocked me and you cursed me. I don't remember that. I remember you told me to cut my dye out my head. I don't remember that. You remember me? We used to talk when I came on your live. No. No, I don't remember that. Some of y'all done got fired on y'all. Some of y'all done got fired from y'all job for watching Carbonation. Bruh. Look at y'all, remember. Look at y'all, scarred. Y'all couldn't wait. Y'all couldn't wait to tell me how y'all felt. Go ahead and get it out, y'all. Let's get it. We gonna do this together, y'all. Go on, get it out. You used to block me. You told Harpo to block me. You told Harpo to block me. Y'all need, look at this. Come on. Y'all couldn't wait to tell me what I did to y'all. Come on, man. I'm telling you, y'all ready? Y'all ready for some Carbonation nostalgia? Y'all want to be scared? Y'all want me to scare y'all real quick? I'm about to scare y'all real quick. Y'all want to get scared? Yeah, I'm about to scare y'all. Y'all want to be scared? Yeah. Y'all scared now, huh? Oh, yeah, that don't mess with you. That don't mess with your mind, huh? Yeah. Scared? Y'all scared now, huh? Yeah, it's getting weird in here now. Yeah, y'all scared, nah. Y'all scared, nah. Y'all scared. Oh, no, Mossy Mama, no. Oh, my God, no. Don't. Oh, I hate that sound. Oh, my God, I hate that greeting. We do not say that in Georgia. Bro, please, Serenity. Oh, my God. Y'all. Oh, my God. Y'all. Oh, my God. Stop, bro. Stop, bro. Come on, Serenity, with the craziness, bro. Do y'all like being re-traumatized? We got some work to do, y'all. So y'all, listen. Don't try to make it seem like we the only ones that need to heal. We all need to heal. Them Green Hearts ain't gonna... Oh, my God, Eddie Murphy. This man done ruined Green Hearts for everybody. Let's talk about all the stuff. Let's talk about all the stuff that Nature Boy ruined. Green Hearts is ruined. What's that dude name he used to play out? The number 3 is just ruined. I only do stuff in 2s and 4s now. What else did he ruin? What's that dude name? That singer, that R&B singer he used to play all the time? Dang, what's that dude name? Man, that dude actually can sing, but I can't listen to him. Not Tank, the other dude. Bruh, I don't know what Yurt mean, bruh. Not Tank, no, bro. But Tank is ruined. R. Kelly ruined himself. R. Kelly didn't need no help ruining himself, bro. Nah, you can't ruin DMX. Not Eric Robinson. It was that dude he was playing all the time at the end. He's not a well-known R&B singer. He kind of like a B-list R&B singer. I can't think of his name. Not Tank. It wasn't Tank, bruh. Yeah, that You Belong to Me song ruined. Oh, that's New York. That's New York slang. Yeah, I'm not from New York. Nah, you can't ruin them. Devin Morrison. Yeah, appreciate that, Sugar Honey. He ruined Devin Morrison. Devin Morrison, if you wonder why your songs ain't getting no plays, Nature Boy. Eddie Murphy, I seen them boys out there. I said, I wasn't going out. Y'all got that rain. You know what I said, Eddie Murphy? They got three. You know what I said, Eddie Murphy? I said, they got three. If I go out there, I'm just going to mess it up. You said he ruined Tyson Bedford? Oh, my God. Yeah, Devin Morrison got ruined. He ruined the number three, Green Hearts. That New York slang sound just, no. I can't even say it. I can't even fix my mouth to say it. Oh, let's not talk about the movies he ruined. Oh, he ruined Pusha P. I can't listen to that song. Ruined that song for me. And he definitely ruined Hairlines. Planet of the Apes, nope, can't watch it. I wasn't into the feathers anyway. East Coast slang? Yeah, he destroyed Whitlock. Yo, that's a good question, Darcelli. That's a mystery to this day. You would have to ask Private Courtney. I don't know. Who was the cameraman for the rain dance? I don't know. He ruined... Nah, not Black Panther movie. Nah, I still... Nah, he can't ruin Black Panther movie, nah. Not... Come on, Brit. Come on, pretty brown skin. Come on, nah. We ain't... Listen. The trick... Oh, my God. This is Triggerville now. This is straight Triggerville. Bruh, I don't even look at my, I can't, bruh. Oh my God, y'all. We're gonna get through this together, y'all. I ain't gonna lie, what destroyed astrology for me was Netflix. I seen an episode about astrology on Netflix that really changed my perspective about the whole concept. Not Pete, no, bro, come on, Denedric. Come on, Denedric. She said tense. Not tense. Oh, yeah, we did lose an hour. It's called Astrology on one of Netflix Explain. I was like, y'all right. He said, I can't even take B6 vitamins no more. I don't even do B6 on Bingo. I just walk out. B6. Nah, I'll leave that on. Nah, he can't ruin Kevin Gates, nah. I can't look at astrology the same. That man ruined Bingo. That boy ruined the sun. I stay in the shade because of Nature Boy. Let it out, y'all. Let it out. We gonna do this together. I don't even go in the sun no more. Yeah, he ruined Pistachio for sure. The green bag. Green bag pistachio sales have plummeted. God dang, pistachio. That boy, they're hell, boy. Tent sales have plummeted. He ruined New York. That boy ruined New York, boy. Dang, New York. Oh, no, I'm going to Walmart now. I'm going to Walmart. He ruined New York. New York, too. He ruined he ruined vacations. That boy ruined vacations. All feathers over with. That boy ruined Clippers. Me either. I ain't like New York. We went up there. That boy ruined thumbs. How you ruin thumbs, bruh? God, dog. I'm telling you, that boy ruined Airbnbs, boy. Nah, he ain't ruined Gold Grills, nah. That he only had that but for a little bit. Nah, we went to Harlem. I think. Don't Sinetta live in Harlem? Nah, he ain't ruined Dancing in the Rain now, cause Omarion and Marcus Houston on You Got Served, he ain't ruined that now. He ruined battery packs. No, nah. That boy ruined interviews. Y'all stupid, boy. Oh my goodness, bruh. Solar panels, y'all. Solar panels plummeted. Sad, bro. I'm telling you, wasting all that. You supposed to be building a nation, but you worried about making sure Hearts is in the room. Stupid. You know what? We're going to give you hell. Man, I seen this lady giving hell to Jim Jones, and Jim Jones been dead for 40 years. We getting that boy hell. We just getting started. It ain't. And I ain't gonna talk about the remaining cult members. But I'm gonna get that bit hell till I get tired. Now, it is sad, Darcelli. You know what's sad? Is there more people out there like him that never gonna get reported? It ain't never gonna serve no jail time.
We got to be on the lookout, bro.
The main point of this is being able to identify these patterns sooner than later. I'm telling you, we spending all this energy shutting the room down. Ain't growing no food. That boy talking about some, I harness my own electricity. Let me tell y'all how boo-boo them solar panels was. It take 32 days to charge a battery pack with them solar panels. Even in the heat of Mexico. I watched it. I'm thinking these solar panels is really about to put out some power. Bro, it takes so long for solar energy to convert to electrical energy. It takes 6 months to charge a phone on that little setup Nature Boy had. He swore, I harness my own electricity. And by harness, he mean pay the light bill. Now, that I see that this is going to be a common question. Do you think he deserves life? Not only do I think he deserved life, so did the state of Georgia. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, I do. Shout out to Georgia. Shout out to Georgia. Thank you, Breeder Boss. You think what you saw was bad. Imagine what wasn't on camera. And for anybody that think he don't deserve life, I wish you would have lived with him for 4 years. We're talking about the mindset. If anybody has an issue with the verdict, take it up with the state of Georgia. I was a witness, not a juror. Get your leak. Ooh, that's hard to quantify, Darcelli. But like I said, even if I did think about it, the way I looked at it as not something I wanted to do, but I looked at it as demons trying to drag me back to hell. What made me leave? Okay, Mama Loxley, this is a common question. We're going to get better and better at answering these. I love the intelligent questions and the legitimate questions. What made you leave? Man, one day I was in the car, and if y'all remember, I was going live on Bego every day. Every day I was going live on Bego. I'd be at the park or I'd be in the car. Mind you, around this time, we had got evicted. So we didn't have no house. And guess what I was doing? Sleeping in the car. And Aya, Malia, Eferu, and Zoka were staying with Imani. I was sleeping in the car. So I got smart and I said, shoot. Gotta take a bath. Gotta brush my teeth. How do I solve this issue? Gym membership. So I got a gym membership, Planet Fitness. Slept outside, Planet Fitness in the back of the car. Woke up, brushed my teeth. At night, take a shower, go to sleep in the car. One day, Mr. Bishop calls and he tells me, hey man, I think you should write books. And I don't know what it was, y'all. I haven't got to that point yet, but it was something about him telling me that I needed to write books that made me realize. It just snapped. Like, I don't know. Have y'all ever snapped before? I'm sure y'all have snapped before. I'm sure y'all have been in a situation where you just snapped. It wasn't anything particular about what was said or what was done, but it was just something about that day. I don't know what it was, like the stars had aligned, but I'm sure y'all done snapped before. So when he said that I should have wrote books, I just snapped because I'm thinking to myself, Negro, you're in jail. I'm sleeping in a car and I'm cleaning myself at a gym. And your recommendation to me is that I write books. I snapped. I freaking snapped. And by snapped, I snapped to myself. And when I snapped, guess what the thought was? Yeah, I don't like to use, I'm working on my profanity. And I try to refrain from using the N-word. Because Malcolm X always said Negro. He never said nigga. So I'm going to say Negro. So I'm thinking to myself, Negro, you are completely out of touch with the dynamics of the situation that we've now found ourselves in. You are recommending, while I'm sleeping in a car and taking showers and brushing my teeth and washing my face at a gym, that I write books. I snap. And I say, okay. And in the moment of me being mad, a voice came, and I think it was my own voice. It said, guess what it said, y'all? And I'm not making this up, yo. It said, you don't have to do this. And I said, and I replied back to myself. I said, you're right. I was about to be mad, but a voice said, you know, you don't have to do this, right? And I'm sitting in the car with the keys. I'm looking around and I'm like, oh, snap. I don't have to do this no more. And so in that moment, it was about 5 o'clock. No, matter of fact, it was about 4:30 because his calls ended at 5. So I'm sitting in the car. He's on the phone with me and the women on three-way. So I was like, okay, all right, yeah, okay. So at 5 o'clock, no, I'm sorry, y'all. Let me get my time right. It was about 12:30 because his phone calls was from 10 to 1 and 5 to 8. And I know it was about 12:30 because Zoka was coming in from wherever she had went. I had to pick her up at the airport at 6 o'clock. So I knew that I was going to have between 1 and 4 to get my mind right. So I said, I'm not going to leave Zoka at the airport. I'm going to pick Zoka up. And once I drop Zoka off, I'm gone. Yeah, that was the last time I spoke to him. So I don't know where Zoka went, but he told her to leave and then he let her come back. So I picked Zoka up. So let me get my time right. So this is about 12:30. I done made my decision. I'm gone. So I said, but I'm not going to do Zoka dirty and leave her at the airport. So Zoka comes in. I pick her up from the airport. And she's telling me about how she's so glad to be back and all that stuff like that. And I drop her off at Imani's house. And this is about, it had to be before 6:30 because it wasn't dark when I dropped them off. So when I dropped Zoka off, I said, I'm not even going to do y'all dirty. I'm going to leave these food stamp cards in the glove box. I'm going to leave these hard drives in the glove box. And I could have did them dirty. I could have hid the food stamps and not said nothing. I said, I ain't going to do y'all dirty. So I said, where's the best place to leave this car so that they can get it? Somewhere where they have eyes on it and it won't be sitting out in the open. Because this Atlanta. So I said, the laundromat. The laundromat stay open 24 hours a day. And it's always people coming in and out. So I parked the car in an area where it could be seen and where it wasn't too far from where they were staying at. I left the keys in the car, left the door unlocked, left the food stamps, left the hard drive. And then I called a Lyft, right? And here's the crazy thing about it, right? I sent them a text message. I forgot to tell y'all, between 1 and 4. Get what I did? I went to T-Mobile. Got me a whole new chip. Got me a whole new chip with a new number that nobody had. And at 8:01, when I knew he wasn't on the phone no more, I sent Aya, Malia, Zoka, and Efru a group chat message that said, the car is at this location. The food stamps is in the glove box. The hard drive is in the glove box. I said, I'm going to keep the phone on for a month. And they also had some stuff in storage. I said, I'm going to keep that open for a month. I sent that text message. I took the chip out the phone, throwed the chip in the trash can, put my new chip in the phone, called the Lyft. And guess what? Lyft came and got me. Guess what my boy pulled up in? I put it on everything. My boy came and picked me up in a Ford Escape. I was like, out of all the whips to come pick me up in, your boy picked me up in a Ford Escape. He took me to the airport. I don't know if y'all know what a groom shuttle is. Them groom shuttles. I got a groom shuttle. Took me to Macon. My homeboy picked me up from Macon. Took me to my grandma high. The next day, I was like, people always be saying Carbonation is a cult. And I said, yeah, Kendra was gone. Kendra and Ja went to Seattle in April. Let me tell y'all about that. So I realized that Atlanta has some of the most elaborate scammers in the United States. Nah, when I ordered the Lyft, it said a Ford Escape. So Kendra and Jar went back to Washington because somebody in the correctional facility was saying that Nature Boy was coming home. They said, yo, he getting out on bond, but he got to have an ankle monitor. And the ankle monitor is $700. You got to put a $350 deposit down to secure the ankle monitor and $350 when he get released. So we ended. But they said, listen, he can't be around no kids. When he get out, he can't be around no kids and he can't be on social media. We were like, all right, bet. So they told Kendra, they were like, look, you got to go because, you know, can't no kids be around. And, you know, Poppy coming home. So, you know, Kendra and Ja leave. Come to find out, we done sent the cash out. Sooner we send the cash out, the phone number stopped answering the phone. Now, mind you, whoever was a part of this scam Bro, they sounded just like a police officer. They sounded just like they work for the system, bro. I'm telling you, BB, straight up, bro. Oh, yeah, he ruined Poppy up, Poppy up. Poppy done. Yeah, someone lied saying he was coming home, and them folk came up on $750. Listen, write down, take pictures. They had us pay for an ankle monitor via Cash App. Whoever that was, shout out to you. I feel like that was a special agent or something, boy. That jump was too smooth. That jump was too smooth. That's one part of the story. I don't think I ever understand what that was about. Because whoever did that, if that was a scam or if that was some type of special agent thing, that don't work, bro. That was the reason. That was the reason why Ja and Kendra left. But them folk was smooth, whoever that was. Oh, and another thing, if y'all want to take the VIP line, you can just call in, because I ain't going to be able to get to all these comments. Y'all see the junk flying. What he be talking about to them on them calls, bruh. They may be talking about how we living on a rock in the middle of nowhere. He talking about how he ain't in jail. He talking about how... What else, bruh? I'm being exonerated. He had them folk eating shrimp noodles and honey buns. Then he told them to start drinking the water out the faucet. He talking about how zero minus one is negative zero. He talking about how they going to be the goddesses of the new earth. Oh, that's a good question. Man, my grandma let me in like I had came home from the club. Shout out to my grandma, man. All that junk I talk, my grandma let me in like I just had came home from the club. Like I ain't been nowhere. Shout out to my grandma. She let me in like I ain't been nowhere. And it was 12 o'clock at night when I showed up. My grandma helped me get my feet back. Helped me get back on my feet, boy. I'm telling you, my grandma let me in like she had seen this before. Oh my goodness. That whole situation changed. Oh, I want to say this, y'all. That whole situation made me change and let go of this whole you 18, you got to get out of my house mentality that we have. You understand what I'm saying? Sometimes I, like, come on, y'all, be honest. Is an 18-year-old really, really ready for the world? Please. I'm telling you, that's old stuff, bro. I'm telling you, that's that old stuff. Shout out to my grandma, man.
God, dog, bro. All right, I got you. I got you, Coco. I seen you tight the 2 times. I wouldn't say more susceptible, but it was something that I used to justify my experience. Tori said something. Shout out to Tori. Tori said something really powerful. In the military, you do undergo certain... Oh, snap. Hold on, y'all. We got to come back. Don't let me forget that, Coco. Hold on. What up, Floop? Like... I wouldn't be able to tell you that. They getting some money from somewhere. They ain't dead. Oh, there go Coco right there. Okay. I just wanted to make sure you back in here because you the one who answered the question. So, if you want to type it again to Coco so I can pin it so people can know what we talking about, but I'll say it verbally. Coco asked, do I feel like my military background made me susceptible? And Tori made a very good point. I won't say that it made me susceptible, but I will say that I used my military background to justify enduring abuse, right? In the military, if you don't know, you go through something called basic training. And in basic training, you are put under certain stressors to help condition you for the stressors of war. It's not designed to torture you. It's not designed to, and contrary to popular belief, it's not designed to break you down. The military does not break you down. They do everything to build you up. And the stressors you go through in the military, it's only for 8 weeks. After you leave that training, they don't talk to you like that. They don't do those things to you. But in Carbonation, it continued and it escalated. And it was designed to break you down. So I kept recalling my military experience in a sense of, I remember being in basic training and things seeming to be hard and challenging. But when I came out on the other side, it ended up making me better. And so I kept telling myself, this is going to make me better. This is going to make me better. This is going to make me better. This is going to make me stronger. This is going to make me tougher. I was not perceiving these things as this is just abuse and it's not going to do anything for you. Have not heard from Nyza in a long time. The last time I heard her voice was, of course, if y'all have seen, she called the police. Shout out to Nyza for calling the police. Oh, yeah, Elmo, good question. I'm glad you reiterated that, Elmo, because I knew it was the second one. I can't say that no other circumstance would have caused me to reach the conclusion that I have never inevitably reached, but I will say that him getting arrested, I've said this over and over again, him getting arrested was a major, major contributing factor to me being able to see things clearly. And shout out to Janae. Shout out to everybody that called the police. Shout out to everybody that did something. Whether you reported a Cash App, reported a page, whatever. Him, and I said it like this, him getting arrested created enough space for me to begin thinking for myself. Exactly. We said it at the same time, Coco. We said it at the exact same time. Him being arrested created enough space for me to think for myself. Because before that, it was Nature Boy 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week. That got reduced to, I would go days without talking to him. And by default, I had to fill in that gap with my own thoughts. And I started slowly challenging the things he was saying. And I was also seeing how disconnected he was from what was actually happening outside the jail. He talking about some zero become one. Nigga, you about to become a prisoner. How did Nature Boy, you talking about how did zero become one? How did Nature Boy become a prisoner? How did Nature Boy become an inmate? You see that? I'm like, this bit dumb. That when I couldn't help it. It wasn't hitting like it used to. He talking about some, how did damn zero become one? Bit, how did you become an inmate? I'm like, this bit dumb. It was like, okay, this bit dumb. And just every day, gradually, he kept confirming that he was dumb. And in that moment when he told me to write that book, I just snapped. Okay, hold on, let's see. Oh, dang. Oh, boy, I'm gonna block you. My bad, Imani. Dang. I done hit remove from live video. I thought you were gone, but it let me cancel it. I was like, dang, that would have been messed up. Okay, I saved it. Did you expect the support you received after leaving? I don't even think I cared. I was just glad to be out. Nah, man, that job would have been a total accident. That would have been a total accident. Okay, hold on. Oh, that's a good question too. So this when I realized that he wasn't as intuitive as he claimed to be. He used to tell me, "Hey, man, you're gonna be a general. I need you to start studying generals and emperors and leaders, because you're going to be leading a whole group of men." And I'm thinking to myself, bruh, I don't give a damn about leading nobody. I didn't even come here for that. Like, I'm thinking to myself, like, this dude's, and he's like, "Listen, when we get out, it's going to be me. You know, I'm going to have my wives. It's going to be you and Sheba and the baby, and I'm thinking to myself, nigga, that is not my vision of the future. And like, he talking about some think east. We're gonna go to the Philippines and keep thinking east. And every time he kept saying like what was gonna come out of this, I'm thinking to myself, like, this Negro is saying things that I don't even care about. I don't care about being no general. I'm realizing we don't have a shared vision here. I don't care. I don't want to be with you and Aya, Efru, and Malia. I don't want to go to no dang Philippines. And one of the main things, like, I remember one time, right? Let me tell y'all about this. I video chat this fool probably about two times. He stayed on video chat with the wives or whatever. Let me start calling them wives. With the current cult members. He video chatted me like twice, but I remember the first time he video chatted me. And this when I realized that me and him was not on the same page. I get the phone. Aya bring me the phone. And he on video chat. And he nodding his head up and down. He smiling. Like, yeah, man. I feel it, man. you really love me, man. I can see it in your eyes. He was like, man, it's going to be all right, man. Don't worry about it. I'm thinking to myself, I am not sad that you in jail right now. I'm like, Negro, before you came down here, I actually was having a good time in a garage. And I had to be honest with myself. I'm like, I am not sad that you are in jail right now. Like, I'm actually more at peace that you're away. I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, yeah, man. You're going to be all right, man. He was like, all right, you get a phone back to Aya. I was like, all right, okay. But let me tell y'all, some of the best times during that time for me was between 1 and 4. 1 and 4 was when he couldn't call. His phone privileges was between 10 and 1 and 5 and 8. Between 1 and 4. Boy, let me tell y'all, that first month, I spent about $300 on E9. I used to stay hopping in the whip. Cause Aya, Porsche, Malia, and Efru didn't know where I was going. And they weren't allowed to talk to me and all that. So I just hop in the whip and be gone. Boy, I was eating like crazy. I mean, one time I went to Chick-fil-A. I went to Chick-fil-A, I ain't care. Boy, I'm talking about I was eating so much, bro. Stayed going to Whole Foods. Stayed eating. I used to love between 1 and 4. God, I know when nobody gonna be able to mess with me. Between 1 and 4. But it just gradually, like, as I got more and more freedom, I'm thinking to myself, like, bruh, when I snapped that day, I'm thinking to myself, do you know you can do this all day, every day? It's like all of these questions start flooding in. It's like, why do you feel responsible for what this dude doing? Bree, they sleep deprived and nutrition deprived because they have to work overtime. They haven't had a good night's sleep in years. I'm telling you, him getting locked up allowed us to get a taste of freedom, and we wanted the whole buffet. When you get a taste of freedom, you want the whole buffet. Yes, ma'am, Coco. Yes, ma'am. I used to hear the women upstairs playing his videos, like on loudspeaker. Exactly, Breeder Boss. Sleep deprivation has very, very powerful impacts on your mental well-being. When I left, I didn't talk to Kendra for 30 days. Because I needed to make sure. Because I was going to leave the United States and not show up. Like, I was going to leave the United States and never to be seen or heard from again. But I thought to myself, man, I can't leave them folk. The thing that prevented me from reaching out to Kendra so early was because I was scared she was going to try to bring me back in. And I knew I was out. I knew I was convinced. And I had to create some distance to say that if she still wanted to do this, I'm gone. Forget that. I was like, if she still want to do this, I'm gone. Forget having a son, all that. I don't want nothing to do with nobody that even remotely remind me of Carbonation. But by that time, she had her own experiences. She had her own time to think for herself. So when I actually called her 30 days later after I left, we was on the same page. She had started looking up Colts. She had started realizing what was going on. And you know, the rest is history. Here we are today. But I ain't talked to Kendra for 30 days, a whole month, because I was about to move to Budapest and be a monk. I was like, bro, because I ain't going to be able to go out here. I was like, man, I want to go out here and enjoy myself, but I don't want to be having folks, hey, man, weren't you that dude that was in Carbonation? Hey, man, hey, ain't you that dude from Carbonation? Hey, man, ain't you that dude that with Nature Boy? I was like, man, I don't want to hear that. I'm moved to goddamn Kazakhstan. I'm telling you, boy, I'm finna move to goddamn Istanbul and never be heard from again. Cause in my mind, I got a sign on my forehead that say, I used to be in Carbonation. Man, you know, your boy tried to introduce that. He was like, hey, man, I would think about, why don't you bring Kendra and the baby back? You know, he didn't say Kendra, but I hate using that cult name. He said, why you don't bring Kendra and the baby back? You know, in my mind, I'm thinking to myself, like, by this time, I had started getting a little bit of my mind back. So I'm thinking to myself, so we can do what? All be in the garage together? I'm thinking to myself, Kendra and John are in a much better situation right now. Why would I take them out of that situation so they can come be with me in the garage? Man, I was like, and I said, bruh, did what I told him. I said, man, if you ain't got your wives, I don't want mine. I said, we got to be in this together. He was like, yeah, that's real, bruh. That's real. I was like, that when I realized, oh, this fool done. I was like, oh, I'm going to pull a U on you. I was like, I got to pull a U on. I was like, I'm going to pull a U on you. I was like, oh, this fool done. Okay, I'm going to pull a U on you now. I was like, okay, so you like to hear stuff like that, huh? Okay, I got your number, Nature Boy. I got your number, boy. So all I got to do is say this cult stuff, and he going to go with it. Bet. I was like, bet. Let me go ahead and say something disciple-like. He gonna go for it. I'm gonna pull a Nature Boy on Nature Boy. I was like, oh, he like to be gassed up like that. All right, bet. All right, yeah, we got your number, homeboy. I was like, what I look like bringing them out of a house into a garage? I was like, let me go ahead and hit him with that coat real quick. He'll go for it. He was like, you dying, bro. You solid, bro. Yeah, stay solid. Because you don't want no distraction. I was like, yeah, stay solid. All I got to do is say stuff like stay solid. You know, he loves that. He loves stay solid, you know. Yeah. You know, I don't want no distractions because it's about you. You know what I'm saying? I got to focus on the primary mission. And that's to get you out of jail. Yeah, you solid. Yeah, you right. Yeah. Let me tell you about that, my boy. Y'all seen that, mind you, right? Notice how Nature Boy had that video where he had them dudes standing behind him like he had created a new cult. Or like he had a new tribe, right? Let me tell y'all that video was sponsored by Honey Buns and Ramen Noodles. He had them boys do that video one time to sell an idea. That video was sponsored by Honey Buns and Ramen Noodles, bro. That man ain't had no new tribe.
That man paid them folk, bro. He paid them folk to do that. Notice how it was no more videos after that. You got all them dudes lined up like that. And you getting stabbed. And you fearing for your life. That don't make no sense. If you was a real gangster and running to jail, you can't, do you know in prison, the real bosses, you can't even get close enough to them to do anything. This man was selling propaganda. He did pay them folk with honey buns and noodles, bruh. How is you running to prison and getting stabbed at the same time? Man, he probably lied, Elmo. He probably lied. He talking about they tried to stab him. He probably lied about that too. They use donation money for all expenses. I don't know nothing about no HIV positive, nah. I don't know nothing about that, nah. I ain't just gonna throw nothing on the man that I don't know to be true, nah. I don't know nothing about that, nah. Oh, the donations finance everything. The Apple Watch paid for by donations. The fake Louis V scarf paid for by donations. And they look expensive, you know, flea market replicas. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, them definitely were paid actors. He said he was stabbed, Velvet. He said that. He said he was stabbed. But you know he'll lie. Just so somebody can feel sorry for him. Shoot, no, they don't work, Hakina. They don't believe in working. They believe in you working and giving them the money. Yeah, he tried. He tried, sugar honey. He tried. There we go. Couldn't have said it better myself. He tell you not to work for money. But want the money you work for. See, let me tell you something. Adolf Hitler said that if you tell a lie long enough and loud enough, it becomes the truth. Who's to say that a plea deal existed? People keep saying plea deal, plea deal, plea deal, plea deal. But where's the paperwork, paperwork, paperwork? And just because they posted paperwork on their page, come on, man, I can make. Do you know what AI can do nowadays? These folks will forge a document. That boy wearing Louis Vuitton. That wasn't no Louis Vuitton. That was Louis Vuitton. Y'all not understanding. All of them girls is talented. Aya can cook her butt off. And Aya can draw. Kayla is multi-talented. Tanisha is multi-talented. Y'all is getting confused with Malia. Zoka is multi-talented. What y'all laughing at, bruh? I'm up here talking about they multi-talented and y'all laughing. What is y'all laughing at? Last time I checked, your boy just went and joined another cult. I think he a Nubian or a Nubian.
a newspaper boy. I don't know. He one of them. You have to ask him what happened to him. He got an Instagram. Oh, y'all laughing at Louis Vuitton. That's what he wearing. So if you want to know what happened to what's your boy name? Logan Leathers. He got a page. Logan Leathers is still online. Go ask him what happened to him. I'm telling you, JoJo, they out here. His name Logan Leathers. He's a New Ibian. Yeah, he wanted them. Tanisha can talk. She's not dumb. Yeah, he said he would stay out so people could feel sorry for him. But yeah, if y'all want to know, listen. The current and the former Carbonation members are still alive. Y'all can go ask them. I don't listen. Y'all can go ask them. Nah, listen, man. All them girls is multi-talented, bro. Right. Ain't nobody say nothing about no stabbing. Ain't nobody say he was in danger of being hurt in court, for the record. Hotel hustlers, bro. I'm telling you. So that go for everybody. Everybody talented and gifted in some way. No, I can't, bruh. I'm telling you, Velvet, he must not been stabbed that bad. That boy still picking up the phone. Or they must stabbed you in your, foot. Cause that hand still work. Nah, that's real, Coco. Like, what the other members are doing, they online. Y'all go see for y'allself what they doing. I think everybody got the right. First of all, what you say on the internet, that's your First Amendment right. I can't say nothing about that. You ain't, just because you don't agree with me, just because you have an opinion about me, what I'm gonna get mad for? You exercising your First Amendment. This ain't North Korea. Well, you can't say what you want to say. I'm glad people get to say what they want to say. That's why I rock with America. You can say what you want to say, believe what you want to believe, and as long as you ain't hurt nobody, can't nobody do nothing about it. So let them folk have an opinion about me. Let them folk heal how they need to heal. I don't care. I'm telling y'all, everybody y'all asking about, they got an Instagram. It ain't Zoka was talented. She still is. She ain't lost the talent. Exactly, Diana. And I challenge you on I challenge you on chess.com. You got 3 days to make a move, so no rush. I ain't going nowhere. Listen, today's Sunday. I'm chilling. This is a Carbonation case study. Oh, yeah. Shout out. Yeah, for sure. Yo, it take too much energy to be mad, bruh. It take too much energy to be mean and nasty and hateful. I don't care if other folk doing it. Oh, no rush, Diana. No rush. No rush. And I want to bring some scientific and psychological analysis to carbonation, because there's enough entertainment and circuit and how you say it? What's the word I'm looking for? There's enough entertainment and foolishness around carbonation. I don't need to add to it. I want to be as serious about this as serious as people are about FLDS. Now, we're going to joke. We're going to have fun. But that's not going to be the theme. Because guarantee, if you see your daughter with a head wrap on, you ain't going to be laughing. I was going to say circuitry, like circus, but that don't make sense. Carbonation is entertainment. It's fun. Until it's your sister. So, yeah, we're going to laugh. Yeah, we're going to have a joke. Yeah, we're going to do that. But that ain't going to be the theme. That is not going to be the theme. Because I promise you, if anybody you know in your family said that they were sexually assaulted, you wouldn't need to know nothing else. That would be enough for you to move out. So let's not even play. Because y'all way too intelligent to be sitting up here making this a circus all day. Yeah, we're going to laugh, of course. We're going to have fun. But dang, you going to make a circus of this 6 hours every day for 6 years? No, ma'am. Carbonation case study. There's a psychological, scientific understanding present here. And we're going to look at that. Because guess what? When you find somebody in your family unexpectedly leave, popping up in Costa Rica, then you're going to want to call me. What do I do? No. Don't call. Nah. Y'all act like y'all have a large pool of black former cult members to go to. Yeah, y'all laugh at us now. Nah. But oh my, how the table's gonna turn. What do I do? No, I don't know. What you asking me for? I'm mad. What you mean? I don't know. What you asking me for? I don't know. This was a joke to you all day. Now, yeah, we gonna joke now. We ain't about to be all uptight all day. Soon as your niece talking about some, he's the Messiah. You gonna be looking for me. What do I do? Nah, what you asking me for? Aaron, my niece is in Nicaragua. Okay, what you telling me? What you telling me for? What you want me to do? No. You thought it was no. No, don't call me. Your sister out there talking about he's the real Jesus. Aaron, what do I do? Shoot, I can't. What you want? Yeah, it's a joke, nah. Yeah. Like if your sister or your niece come and tell you they were sexually assaulted, and you gonna be like, well, you chose to go over there. Y'all, some of y'all folks so re-re. As if that response is something you would actually use in real life. This internet be having folk just losing all their compassion and empathy. If your daughter or your sister or your niece came and said, I was sexually assaulted, you think you're going to be like, well, you shouldn't have went over there. Well, you shouldn't have been wearing that dress. You chose to go over there. Come on, man. I know, Diana. And that's why we gotta change the culture, man. Why is the victims more scared than the perpetrators? Come on, man, we gotta do something about that. That's why I'm gonna continue to talk about Lee Joe Bishop to scare these Negroes. I see y'all. Y'all think y'all alpha males, huh? We got a place for y'all. Yeah, we're going to make sure. Yeah, so you can't say you ain't know. Yeah, appreciate that, Lee Joe Bishop. You did do one thing. You did one thing right. You showed these Negroes an example of what not to do. So the next Negro that come over here, you can't say you ain't know. Yeah, you an alpha male. Yeah, I'm a polygamist. Yeah, all right. Okay. Okay. Yeah, you see how I got all these women? Yeah, all right. You going to be in that same white T-shirt. Go ahead and get your white T-shirt game up. That boy Nature Boy got on tall T like he about to be. That boy look like he about to snap his fingers and do the step. And you can do it all by yourself. that boy Nature Boy look like Fable. I said, dang, Nature Boy, you got on that tall T. Do it. That boy Nature Boy look like, do it. Lean with it. Rock with it. That boy Nature Boy looked like I did when I was in 8th grade, boy. God, dog, that boy looked like snap your fingers. That boy made me want to do lean with it. Rock with it. I'm telling you. Yeah, listen. All y'all dudes out there, y'all should be scared. Cause we come from, that boy look like, dun, 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 you. That boy, Nature Boy look like you. That boy, Nature Boy look like, Nature Boy, you!
Soldier Boy, tough. Hey, I got this new damn for y'all called a Soldier Boy. You just gotta punch, then crank back 3 times from left to right. Soldier Boy, I'm in it. Oh. Why me crank it? Why me roll? Why me crank that Soldier Boy? That Superman, that all. Oh. Now why me you? Crank that Soldier Boy.
Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier Boy.
Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier Boy.
Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy.
Soldier Boy, I'm in it.
Oh.
Why me crank it? Why me
roll?
Why me crank that Soldier Boy? That Superman, that all.
Oh.
Now why me
you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy. Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy. Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy. Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy. Now why?
Soldier Boy, I'm in it.
Oh.
Why me lean that? Why me rock?
Superman, that all. Oh.
Why me crank that RoboCop? Super friend, now why me jock? Jocking on them, hate them, man. When I do that Soldier Boy, I lean to the left and crank that thing now.
You!
I'm jocking on you,
I'm jocking on you.
And if we get the fight, then I'm cocking on you.
I'm cocking on you.
You catch me at your local party, yes, I crank it every day. Haters get mad, cause I got me some bathing ape.
Soldier Boy, I'm in it.
Oh.
Why me crank it? Why me roll?
Why me crank that Soldier Boy? That Superman, that all.
Now why me?
Crank that Soldier Boy.
Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier Boy.
Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy.
Now why? Soldier Boy, I'm in it.
Why me crank it? Why me roll?
Why me crank that Soldier Boy? That Superman, that all.
Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy.
Now why me you?
Crank that Soldier
Boy.
Now why?
I'm bouncing on my toes.
Why me super soaked?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'ma pass to A-Rab and he gon' crank it up for sure.
Haters wanna beat me, Soldier Boy. I'm the man, they be looking at my neck, saying it's the rubber band, man.
Why me do it?
Why we do it?
Damn,
let it to
let
it.
No, you can't do it like me, though. So don't do it like me, folk. I seen you try to do it like me, man. That damn was ugly.
Soldier Boy, I'm in it.
Oh.
Why me crank it? Why me roll?
Why me crank that Soldier Boy? That Superman, that all.
Now why me?
Crank that Soldier
Boy. Now why me?
You.
that song.
Now
boy.
I mean you.
Crank that song.
Now
boy.
I mean you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
Soulja Boy, I been it.
Oh.
Why me crank it? Why me
roll?
Why me crank that Soulja Boy? The Superman.
Now, oh.
Now I mean you.
Crank that song.
Now
what?
I mean you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
I mean you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
I mean you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
All too fresh, I been it.
Oh.
Why me crank it? Why me?
Roll.
Why me crank that Roosevelt and super soak that?
Oh.
Super soak that.
Oh.
Super soak that,
oh.
Super soak that,
oh.
Super soak that,
oh.
On to friend, now why me?
Dude.
Why me shuffle? Why me?
You.
Why me crank that Soulja Boy? Now Superman,
you.
Superman,
do it.
Superman,
do it.
Soulja Boy, I'm in it.
Oh.
Why me crank it? Why me
roll?
Why me crank that Soulja Boy? That Superman, that,
oh.
Now why me?
Crank that Soulja
Boy. Now why me?
You.
Crank that Soulja
Boy. Now why me?
You. Crank that song.
Now what?
I mean
you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
Soulja Boy, I been it.
Oh.
Why me crank it? Why me
roll?
Why me crank that Soulja Boy? The Superman.
Oh.
Now what? I mean
you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
I mean
you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
I mean
you.
Crank that song.
Now what?
I mean
you.
Crank that song.
Now what?